what we want to prove is that both parties obtain the same key. For the server to obtain the key, it needed to be able to decrypt this message using the password. And so what we're going to add to the message is, instead of just sending this value, we're going to also send a challenge. And that challenge is going to be encrypted using the key. And the challenge is just some random value selected by the server. And now Alice needs to be able to obtain the right key that proves that she knew the password. And using that key, well, she can decrypt this message and obtain R. This effectively demonstrates to Alice that she's talking to the right server, at least a server that knew her password, because the key that's produced here could only be produced correctly if the server was able to decrypt the message that Alice sent, encrypted with that password. This hasn't yet proven anything to the server, so to finish the protocol, Alice has to send a response back to the server that proves that she was able to obtain R. So Alice could do this by proving that she learned R, so she could send the message, encrypting with the key, R back to the server. So does this work?